So with the Chargers' big win, the AFC West standings look like this. KC and LA both tied at 11-3, but because of those division records, the Chiefs have the tiebreaker and the top seed in the AFC. What a wild finish this was on Thursday night. I came out there on Thursday night. I was ready for our post-game show. I had all of my notes. Like,
all your Chiefs wins.
Lined up, all of my Chiefs stats, and then it was just like, tear it all up, throw it away. It was such an unbelievable finish. What was your biggest takeaway from that game?
Well, we knew the record and the narrative going in that Kansas City had had his way with San Diego. With the Los Angeles Chargers, but really what they showed me is the mental toughness that this team has. You know, it's always been a narrative with the Chargers that they've dealt with injuries. Well, they dealt with one this game in Keenan Allen, and the old man, Father Time, Benjamin Button, Antonio Gates showed up. You know, four receptions.
He was juking guys. 54.
Yeah, he's always been quick. Always been fat like that ever since high school. It's all good. But really, it's the mental toughness, and Anthony Lynn has instilled the mental toughness in this team. That's why they're dangerous, whether they're going to win the division or if they're going to be a wild card, because Phillip Rivers is just finding ways to get guys open. You talk about on that last drive, you know, picking up a 2nd and 20, picking up on multiple fourth downs, and then to have the nerve to go for the win on the road, two-point conversion after coming back 14 down, just shows, you know, the toughness and the belief that he has in Phillip Rivers in that offense.
Anthony Lynn was like, I didn't come here to tie. Yeah. I came here to win.
If you're on the road and you've got the momentum, we've seen teams that have kicked the extra point. I believe it was the Bears here against the Giants a couple of weeks ago where they had that thrilling comeback. You got a team on its heels. Go for two. Go for the kill shot, especially on the road. And speaking of the road, one of the things that really has impressed me with the Chargers, and in talking to the folks there, you know, their home games are kind of like road games. They've got so many fans of the other team coming in there, so they really don't have that. So they were saying earlier this year, we kind of get the feeling like we could play anywhere. You know, we played a game in London. We played a game, played our games at home. Well, now they've gone into Pittsburgh, won in thrilling fashion. They went into Kansas City, won in thrilling fashion. So you're looking at it now, say, well, boy, they got to get a home game. They got to buy. You know, even if they don't, boy, it's a dangerous team going into the playoffs that you don't want to see in your own building, knowing what they've done in those buildings.
To do it at Arrowhead, too, where Phillip Rivers and the Chargers, they lost 9 straight to the Chiefs, and it felt like it was going to be 10 straight. And then all of a sudden, I mean, that was just, it was so impressive. And like you mentioned, Phillip Rivers on the road, I think he has one of the best touchdown to interception ratios this year on the road. So it doesn't even matter where he's playing. What did you think? What was your biggest takeaway?
Well, after that Monday night game, that famous Monday night game with the Rams and the Chiefs, and there were a ton of points scored, once everybody kind of came back down to reality, one of the questions that I posed was, how can these teams be effective in the postseason when they're getting such poor defensive play? And that's what I saw from the Kansas City Chiefs defense. I saw poor defensive play, and I saw mistakes that they have been making all season long. I saw holes in that defense that have been there all season long, and it finally ended up hurting them when they needed their defense the most. That two-point conversion, where it was a very, very simple, and you back me up on this, Mark, very simple read. You playing man coverage, one guy goes right, that guy runs with him, the other guy goes left. And so I saw the inside corner make the signal. The right corner obviously didn't get the call, but these are the kind of plays that have been happening to this defense all season long. So Andy Reid has to improve. They got to improve on that side of the football.
I think
Reg, I take the gray out. I name names. Orlando Scandrick was point check.
Right.
So let's just call it what it is. What happens is a lack of communication. And the reason I can speak on that is because that's my defense.
Yeah.
Bob Sutton was my linebacker coach here. I know exactly what it was. It was a combination coverage. And really what the problem was, you had two corners on the same level. Mm-hmm. Whenever the receiver is one on the ball, one's off the ball, somebody has to press the point.
That's right.
And the other corner has to play off so you can read what the other corner does.
Malcolm
read
Butler the route. In the Super Bowl.
And you can read the route combinations. Also, they added something else to it because it looked like it was a zero blitz all out man-to-man all across. I believe it was Houston or the defensive end dropped back. So you have protection inside and short. Orlando Scandrick, point shaving. Yeah. Get your checkup.
I think you could really notice, too. I know it was Eric Berry's first game back in so long, but you could really tell the difference from the first half to the second half with that defense when he was out for the whole second half. That's when the Chargers and Phillip Rivers really started to heat up.
He's the communicator.
Yeah.
And that was the plan going in. They're hopefully going to expand it as they go along. They just wanted him to survive this game here, which he did. A lot of times you hear, though, like what's happening up front, if you've got a pass rush, that's covering things in the back end. That pass rush is doing all they could and still exposing that back end.
Phillip Rivers throws with such anticipation. Got him in trouble right before the half, right? He threw the interception, but he knows he doesn't have the protection. So he's throwing the ball and throwing guys open.
And he mentioned the interception on our show twice. He had gotten sacked 5 times in that game, so he saw pressure all night. He made some mistakes. They didn't have Keenan Allen out there for the whole second half. He didn't have his top two rushers, and he was still able to help the Rams win at the
San Diego Chargers, right?
Get out of here with that. What a win for them. What a game.